Welcome back to STS. In today's video, we're going to find the GCF, or the greatest common factor, and the LCM, which is also known as the least common multiple. And we're going to use factoring, and then we're going to use prime factorization method to show how we can get to these answers quicker. So let's begin. Let's say we have the numbers 36 and the number 24. All right, the way that you might be most familiar with is actually listing all the factors to find the GCF. So for 36, we know it's 1 and 36. We know 2 and 18, 3 and 12, 4 and 9, 5 doesn't work, 6 does work, and then we can stop because we know 6 times 6. So the factors of 36 are as follows. Now let's do the factors of 24. 1 and 24, 2 and 12, 3 and 8, 4 and 6, 5 doesn't work, and we already have 6. So now to find the greatest common factor, we're trying to find the number that's the largest that they both have in common. So we see here that 12 would be the GCF. All right, and if we were to find the LCM, or least common multiple, we'd have to list the multiples of these numbers. So let's begin with 36. So the first is 36 times 1 is 36. 36 times 2 would be 72. And 36 times 3 would be 108. Now let's work with 24. 24 times 1 would be 24. 24 times 2 would be 48. Let's erase that. Fix would be 48, and then 24 times 3 would be 72, and we see that they have 72 in common, so 72 would be the LCM. All right, and this here is what I would call, or what I would consider, the long way. A faster method would be to use something called prime factorization. And that's where we list a number as the product of its prime factor. So let's take a look at an example. Let's go ahead and change the color. Let's go to blue here. So again, we're going to work with 36. The factors of 36, or one set of factors for 36, would be 9 and 4. To get 9, that'd be 3 times 3. And to get 4, that would be 2 times 2. Here we have our listing of our prime factors. So 36 is really the same thing as 2 to the second times 3 to the second. And then let's do the prime factorization for 24. To get 24, that's actually 6 times 4. And I could use 3 and 2. And then for 4, its factors are 2 and 2. So I have 3, 2, 2, and 2. Another way to say 24 would be 2 to the third power times 3. Now, if we wanted to find the GCF using this method, we would find out what factors are in common. We see there's a 2 in common to both, so now we're going to use a 2. The other factor in common to both we see is a 3, so we know that we're going to use a 3. The next thing we have to do is look at the powers for the factors that they have in common. When we look at the 2, we see that this has a power of 2. And for this one, we have a power of 3. We need to take the factor that has the smallest exponent, or the smallest power. So we're going to use 2 to the second power. And we do the same thing for the factors of the common factor of 3. Here I have 3 to the second, and over here this is understood to be 3 to the first. So I'm going to use 3 to the first. Now I need to just break this down. 2 to the second power is 4. 3 to the first is 3. And we see 4 times 3 is in fact 12, and that's the same thing we received when we did it using the long method. For the LCM, we follow a similar procedure. First, we list all the factors that they have, whether they're in common or not. So here we have a 2, and again we have a 3, and there are no other factors. Now we look to the powers of those factors, and now we want the largest exponent, or power, for that factor. So here we have 2 to the third, which would be the largest for the factor of 2, and then 3 to the second would be the largest for the factors of 3, and then we expand. 2 to the 3rd is 8, and 3 to the 2nd is 9. And here we see 8 times 9 is in fact 72. And again, we see that is the same thing that we came out with when we used the long method by hand. And then one last thing is we're going to call up the calculator, and we're just going to verify these answers using the TI 84 plus. To do that, we're going to go down to math, and then we're going to click the right arrow to go over to num, and then let's do the GCF first. Here they're saying GCD. GCD stands for greatest common divisor. Divisors and factors are the same thing. So let's press 9 for that. And the numbers that we've used here are 36, and the other number is 24. And we're expecting that GCF or GCD to come out to be 12. We click enter, and we see it is in fact 12. Let's click on math again. Let's right arrow, and let's go down to 8, which is LCM for least common multiple. We're going to put in these same numbers, 36 and 24. And as we did by hand, we're expecting the answer to be 72. Let's press enter, and we see the answer is in fact 72. All right, so that sums it up for this video by Speller Tutorial Services. Please friend us on Facebook and also subscribe to that YouTube channel. And as always, thank you for watching.